It's the end of the year, and here at iFixit, we like to take some time to reflect on all the devices we've taken apart, including the ones that impressed us the most, and the ones that were pretty disappointing. Here are the least repairable devices of 2017. You'd think laptops would be easy enough to make repairable, but our teardown of the 2017 Retina MacBook showed exactly how to make one that is practically impossible to repair. With its RAM, flash memory, and processors all being soldered to the logic board, a battery that's thoroughly glued to the lower case, and a fused Retina display, Apple has made a laptop that's impossible to upgrade and extremely difficult to fix. As a result, we gave it a 1 out of 10 on our repairability scale. Tablets have never been super repairable devices, but considering an HP tablet scored a perfect 10 out of 10, you'd think Apple could do better than a 2, which is what the 2017 version of the iPad scored. Not only was it glued shut just like all the other iPads, the front panel connector was trapped under the LCD, there were gobs of adhesive holding just about everything in place, and the LCD was adhered to the front panel, making it more likely to be shattered during disassembly. When you find yourself trying to freeze a phone open, you know the score is going to be low. And that's just what happened with this year's Essential phone. Heat was no match for the adhesive on the Essential phone, so we broke out the freeze spray, and thanks to nearly invisible seams, we shattered the glass trying to get the phone open. Not only that, but the USB-C port was also soldered to the motherboard. All things considered, it's no surprise that the Essential phone scored a 1 out of 10. And when it comes to the worst of the worst for the year, there really wasn't much competition. Microsoft released a series of products that didn't even score above a 1. The Surface Pro 5 was the first to get a 1 out of 10 due to its glued-in display and battery, non-standard connectors, and its no longer replaceable SSD. And then came the Surface Book 2, which also scored a 1 out of 10, thanks to its fused glass panel and LCD, the RAM and processor that was soldered to the motherboard, and due to some tricky-to-access connectors, any repairs you could do would require a full motherboard removal. But nothing prepared us for the Surface laptop, a glued-together monstrosity that required literally tearing the device apart to get inside. But once we were in, things didn't improve much. The CPU, RAM, and onboard storage were all soldered to the motherboard, and lastly, the battery was firmly glued in place. When it was finally over, the Surface laptop walked away with a staggering 0 out of 10. We're hoping that 2018 brings us devices that are easier to repair, but in the meantime, if you want to relive our pain, check out the teardown links in the description below, and have a happy new year.